Okay, so let's talk about a clip from the Candace Owens show. And yes, unfortunately, that is a thing. Now, if you know anything about Candace Owens, you know that he absolutely hates transgender people. And is always saying some transphobic, explicitly hateful thing about this marginalized and vulnerable community. But in this particular clip that I'm about to play for you, Candace Owens is going to take the trans hate and he's going to turn it up to an 11. So let's go ahead and watch. It's a short clip, but I have so much to say about this. I could talk about this literally for hours possibly, but I'll break it down for you and why everything that he's saying here is disgusting.
I'm actually like staunchly conservative when it comes to the trans debate, and people say, oh, well, even if a person is trans, you should have the decency and the respect to call them by their preferred pronoun. I don't play that game. And what I always say to people is, if you have a mental disorder, that's fine. You know, I don't need to come up to you and tell you that I think you have a mental disorder. That would be rude.
Right.
But when you have a mental disorder and you're now requiring that I have a mental disorder, right, to meet your mental disorder, that doesn't work for me. Which is to say that if somebody was walking around as a schizophrenic and saying that they were Superman, and then telling me that I was required to treat them like Superman, I wouldn't play the game. Mm-hmm. That's how I feel about trans. I think the slope is so slippery, and they find that to be bigotry. No, I don't need to, I'm not going to call you she, I'm not going to call you her, just because you're a grown man and you're wearing a wig and a dress. That's literally telling me that I am now required to have a mental disorder because you have one.
I try to do it in public where I will not use the fake pronoun. So now it's so confusing because if there's a man who thinks he's a woman and you refer to him as a man, what the culture tells you is you're misgendering him.
Right.
The only people misgendering anybody are the ones pretending the man is a woman.
That's correct.
So I refuse to refer to the man as she. However, in an interpersonal, if we were at a dinner party or something, I will use whatever language he wants me to use to refer to him, in the same way that if there were a schizophrenic at a dinner party, I would indulge the delusion that there were voices speaking.
I mean,
it is obviously it's a psychological condition, but what the left wants is to have their cake and eat it too. They want to say, this is a very serious psychological condition and you have to indulge it. Also, you have to treat it as though it's objectively true.
Right.
That's where
Change the bathroom signs now, right?
Change
because this person now needs to feel like there's a place for them to go that's safe. And I'm like, could you imagine a world, take it out of the trans debate, where we had to now accommodate everyone that was suffering with schizophrenia and we needed to make the world look like as they were seeing it or the voices that they were hearing. We needed to basically get on our knees and support whatever it is that they were saying. People would say that was crazy, that was nuts, but they think it's different somehow with the trans debate. And I don't know why the trans debate is now being steamrolled into the LGB debate.
How is that not obvious to you? How do you not recognize the commonality between all people within the broad LGBTQ+ category? The reason why we put LGB and T in the same category is because we all violate the same sex and gender norms. I don't know how she hasn't picked up on this yet, since she talks about it all the time, but I mean, when you are born, and let's say you're born with a penis, well, society ascribes a role to you. You're supposed to act masculine. You're supposed to be attracted to women and date women and have sexual intercourse with women. And if you're born with a vagina, you're supposed to act feminine and express yourself that way and wear dresses and have long hair and date men and be attracted to men. But not everyone fits neatly into one box. Lesbians, gays, and bisexuals, as well as transgender people and non-binary people, don't conform, but yet we still are discriminated against because we violate the same sex and gender norms that have been assigned to us at birth. That's why we put all of them in the same category. I don't even know how this isn't obvious at this point, but everything that Candace Owens says here, he takes the hate and he takes it further than ever before. And by the way, since Candace Owens isn't going to respect the preferred pronouns of transgender people, then I have absolutely no reason to respect his preferred pronouns. So I'm assuming that Candace would like to use she, her pronouns, but I mean, I'm not going to respect hers if she's not going to respect trans people's. So I will be using male pronouns to refer to Candace Owens, because if you want to be a dick to trans people, then you need to expect that there are going to be people that will give you a taste of your own medicine. So let's break down why what he said here is utterly fucking absurd. It's incorrect And it's laughable. Like, this is stupidity that we just saw. Quote, I'm staunchly conservative when it comes to the trans debate. And people say, oh, well, even if a person is trans, you should have the decency and respect to call them by their preferred pronoun. I don't play that game. Okay, so I won't play that game either. But how is this a game? Like, respecting people and not being dicks to people? That's a game to Candace Owens. Respecting the wishes of someone is a game to her. Oh no, I don't have to play that game because it's a fact, scientifically speaking, because I definitely know what I'm talking about, that you are not biologically male or female. So I don't have to play that quote unquote game because facts first. Facts don't care about your feelings. But when it comes to climate change,
I don't believe this, like, at all, just so you know.
Quote, when you have a mental disorder and you're now requiring that I have a mental disorder to meet your mental disorder, that doesn't work for me. That's now literally requiring me to have a mental disorder because you have one. In other words, if you are a trans person and you expect me to use your preferred pronouns, well, I'm just buying into your delusions. Because if somebody is hallucinating and they see a bunch of bugs crawling on the wall and they're not there, then why should I have to play to that and say, oh, you know, you're correct, there are bugs crawling on the wall. No, I don't have to do that. So what she's saying here is really dumb. And the example that she uses, like, she creates an analogy to demonstrate why we shouldn't do this. Quote, if somebody were walking around as a schizophrenic and telling me they're Superman, I'm required to treat them like they're Superman? I wouldn't play that game. Understand why this is such an idiotic comparison to make. It's obviously a false equivalence, but it's just downright fucking dumb. Like, there are people in the world that express themselves as either masculine or feminine, somewhere in between or somewhere outside of that spectrum. But there is nobody in the world who is capable of flying and having superhuman strength. Like, do you understand why these are not the same things, Candace? One of them actually is not realistic in the laws of physics. Like, somebody can't literally be Superman, but somebody can express a gender identity. We all do it. So what are you talking about? What are you even talking about? Obviously, this is a false equivalence, but understand what she's doing here. It's so stupid. She's essentially saying that gender dysphoria and schizophrenia, these are comparable. These are basically the same things. Take it from me, because I definitely know more than the American Psychological Association. I know more than the American Medical Association. So disregard what they say about gender dysphoria and mental health and listen to what I say. And what she says is basically, look, you've got to rip the Band-Aid off. You need to tell people that you were born male, so you're a man. Don't buy into their delusions, according to Candace Owens. I mean, what she's essentially proposing here is a type of cognitive behavioral exposure type therapy to trans people, where you believe that, you know, the best way to overcome a mental health issue or something that you're fearful of, more specifically, is you get exposure to it. What she's saying is, you know, if trans people are given the same type of recommendation, if we tell them, just be exposed to what makes you feel uncomfortable, that is your original gender that was assigned to you at birth on the basis of your sex, then obviously that's a way to overcome it. So I'm actually helping you. Because by saying, no, you're not actually a man, I'm exposing you to the reality of the situation, and that's good for you. Except there's a flaw with this line of thinking and why it's obviously a false equivalence. Transgender people have undergone the most extensive exposure therapy imaginable. They lived their lives as the gender that they don't identify with. They have a brain that is the opposite gender than the one that was assigned to them. So they've been exposed to it, and they didn't just willy-nilly decide, you know what, I think I want to try living as the opposite gender or a non-binary gender just to see how it feels. They've been exposed to it. So this is why I'm saying, when you start getting in the realm of psychology and you start trying to analyze or psychoanalyze transgender people, my response is shut the fuck up, Candace, because you obviously have no clue what you're talking about.
Don't you find it odd that plastic surgery can cure a mental disorder?
This reminds me of, there was a subreddit before. I don't remember what it was called. It was either called Fat Hate or Fat People Hate. And essentially what the members of this subreddit would do was they would take pictures of unsuspecting overweight people, post it to the subreddit, And then everyone would make fun of them and say, wow, how disgusting it is that this person is overweight. Now, what's insane about this is people in this subreddit, they actually deluded themselves into thinking that they weren't just bullying people who were overweight. They were actually doing something good, because the idea was, if we just make fun of these people, that will give them the courage to change, because they'll see how disgusting we think they are, and then that will encourage them to lose weight. A problem, though, is that this doesn't work. Shaming people into doing what you think is best for them is never a strategy that is best for them. In fact, it's incredibly destructive. And as she says this about trans people, she acts like she's saying something revolutionary. Like, do you realize that for every historically marginalized and oppressed group in society, this has been the same response? Like, you're not proposing anything new and innovative. What did we say about gay people? It's a mental disorder. If we just force them to date the opposite gender, then eventually they'll get over it. Oh, what's that? You want to be in an interracial relationship? Don't you know that this is not natural? So we should tell them directly that we disapprove. Oh, what's that? You're a slave and you think you should have equal rights as me, a white property owner? Well, I should tell you that you're being delusional here. I mean, what she's saying is completely old. It's been what we use to justify bigotry against marginalized communities. But what Candace Owens is saying is, look, I have the solution. We just have to treat transgender people like shit enough to where they'll detransition and then they'll go away and this won't be an issue. But it's incredibly hateful. You're literally encouraging hatred. You're encouraging hatred. And history is going to judge you, Candace, very harshly because of this. Now, I know that Candace Owens himself will be fine, right? Candace Owens is always going to be able to make money off of this grift so long as she remains committed to this right-wing conservative ideology, because there's going to be, you know, a market need for her type of shilling. But for the people who watch Candace Owens, who actually respect her and take what she's saying seriously, they're going to make social media posts about transgender people and how horrible they are and disgusting they are. And then 10, 15 years down the line, when transgender people are actually fully accepted and have full rights, because that's going to happen, we will win this battle, then these people will get fired. They'll have to come out and apologize. But look, you don't even have to put yourself through all of this misery. We've seen this story play out before. Civil rights will be won for transgender people. And we're never going to fully get 100% success rate in terms of social acceptance. But by and large, just like gay people, the tide will turn in their favor. It's just a matter of when will that happen and which side do you want to be on? Because this isn't a debate, Candace. It's non-debatable. We don't debate whether or not we treat people who are different than us as equals. We just treat them equally, and those who don't will be judged very harshly by history. So that's all I'll say. I'll leave it there, because I could talk about this for a really long time, because this is personal to me. Like, I am part of the LGBTQ community. I may be cisgender, but these are my people. These are my people. And so you are actively encouraging people to treat them poorly. And you're trying to do that under the guise of, oh, no, I'm helping them. I promise you. Get the fuck out of here. You're disgusting. You're a transphobic bigot. And I really do hope that you one day regret the way that you feel. I hope that you wake up. Because being hateful, it may pay off for you in the short term, but long term, you're not helping yourself. And you're certainly not helping society, Candace.